डिस्कस कर रहे थे स्ट्रिपिंग का, आई गेस स्ट्रिपिंग का कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर हो गया है विथ डिलीशन. ओके
ओके मैम,
ठीक है, कोई और इश्यू हो तो बोलना. नेक्स्ट हम लोग आते हैं, हम लोग का तीन फंक्शन है, आर जस्ट, एल जस्ट एंड सेंटर. ठीक है, तो ये वाले में क्या होता है, ये तुम्हारा एडजस्ट करता है. सपोज कि तुम्हारा फुल नेम का साइज है 20 कैरेक्टर्स, राइट, एंड देन तुम्हें कुछ सेट ऑफ सपोज स्पेशल कैरेक्टर्स, ऐसा सिचुएशन है कि तुम्हें कुछ कैरेक्टर्स को कॉन्कैटिनेट करना है सच दैट द लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग बिकम्स सपोज 30, राइट. तो इस केस में ये एड जस्ट एल जस्ट जो है ये हमारा स्ट्रिंग कॉन्कैटिनेशन करता है. कौन सा मतलब कैरेक्टर कॉन्कैटिनेशन करेगा इंस्टेड, जैसे मैंने डॉट कैरेक्टर दिया है तो इसका टोटल साइज कर देगा 30 एंड राइट हैंड साइड में सारा डॉट कैरेक्टर कॉन्कैटिनेट हो जाएगा इफ़ यू आर यूजिंग आर जस्ट. इफ़ यू आर यूजिंग एल जस्ट देन ये अगेन तुम्हारा फुल नेम का साइज विल बी 30 एंड दीज डॉट्स विल बी एडजस्टेड एट द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड. एंड सिमिलरली सेंटर में ये तुम्हारा जो फुल नेम का स्ट्रिंग है इसको सेंटर में रख के लेफ्ट एंड राइट में एडजस्टमेंट करेगा सच दैट द कंप्लीट साइज ऑफ योर फुल नेम बिकम्स 30 कैरेक्टर. क्लियर?
ओके, यस मैम.
तो इसको हम लोग एक बार रन करके चेक कर सकते हैं. सपोज इसमें बहुत सारा है, यू हैव टू जस्ट फोकस ऑन द एल जस्ट आर जस्ट पार्ट, दिस वन. ठीक है, इसमें टोटल साइज मेरा 30 कैरेक्टर हो गया है एंड जो तुम्हारा एल जस्ट है. ओके, सो आई गेस एक चीज मैंने गलती किया, आर जस्ट जो है ना वो तुम्हारा लेफ्ट हैंड साइड में करेगा एंड तुम्हारा फुल नेम जो है वो तुम्हारा राइट हैंड साइड शिफ्ट हो जाएगा. तो फर्स्ट केस में सारे डॉट्स लेफ्ट में आएंगे, ठीक है. सेकेंड केस एल जस्ट जो है मतलब योर नेम फुल नेम विल बी लेफ्ट एडजस्टेड एंड जो तुम्हारा स्पेशल कैरेक्टर है वो राइट हैंड साइड में आ जाएगा. ये डॉट मैंने यूज़ किया, ये कुछ भी हो सकता है. एंड सेंटर के केस में योर स्ट्रिंग विल बी सेंटर्ड एंड जो भी स्पेशल कैरेक्टर्स है वो तुम्हारे लेफ्ट एंड राइट हैंड साइड में आ जाएंगे.
ओके
ओके,
मेक सेंस मैम.
कॉन्सेप्ट वाइज सेम है, जस्ट लर्निंग वाइज आर जस्ट मीन्स राइट हैंड साइड में एडजस्टमेंट होगा, मेरे स्ट्रिंग राइट हैंड साइड में आ जाएंगे, जस्ट दैट. एंड चॉप क्या करता है, चॉप जो है लास्ट से हमारा कैरेक्टर को डिलीट कर देता है. तो जैसे मैंने चॉप यूज़ किया है तो हम लोग जैसे सपोज माई जस्टिन रॉस मैंने कंसिडर किया है, डबल एस था तो ये सिंगल एस हटा दिया. तो चॉप फंक्शन विल डिलीट आवर स्ट्रिंग फ्रॉम राइट साइड, ठीक है. चॉम्प भी सिमिलरली काम करता है लेकिन तुम्हारा चॉम्प के केस में हमें स्ट्रिंग बताना पड़ता है, ठीक है. सपोज कि चॉम्प के केस में मैंने कहा एस एस तो ये जो है ये हमारा लास्ट का दो कैरेक्टर को हटा देगा, ठीक है.
ओके,
तो चॉप इज रिमूविंग वन कैरेक्टर एट अ टाइम एंड चॉम्प के केस में वी आर स्पेसिफाइंग व्हाट हाउ मेनी कैरेक्टर टू रिमूव. सपोज इफ आई से यहाँ पे इफ आई से ओ एस एस देन अगेन तुम्हारा तीन वैल्यू हट जाएगा तो तुम्हारा यहाँ पे इतना सा कैरेक्टर्स मिलेगा, राइट.
ये सारा सिर्फ चॉप या चॉम्प के लिए लास्ट में ही होता है ना,
राइट. ये तुम्हारा राइट से रिमूव करता है, ठीक है. एंड अगेन डिलीट जो है, जैसे मैंने अभी हम लोग यहाँ पे जो डिलीट यूज कर रहे हैं वो स्पेस रिमूवल के लिए है. वो डिलीट जो है वो कोई भी कैरेक्टर जो रीड करता है वो उसको रिमूव कर देता है. तो इंस्टेड ऑफ स्पेस वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज आई एनी कैरेक्टर. तो ये जहाँ जहाँ इस कैरेक्टर को रीड कर रहा है इट विल रिमूव दोज कैरेक्टर्स. सो हमारे केस में इफ से डिलीट आई तो हम लोग को पता है कि मार्टिन के सॉरी माइक के केस में हमारा एक आई है एंड जस्टिन के केस में एक आई है. तो यू विल गेट आउटपुट लाइक दिस जहाँ पे सारे आईज रिमूव हो चुके हैं.
ओके,
ठीक है. तो डिलीट जो है दैट विल रीड द कैरेक्टर एंड इट विल रिमूव वेर एवर इट फाइंड दैट पर्टिकुलर कैरेक्टर इन द स्ट्रिंग, ठीक है. नाउ नेक्स्ट है हमारा स्प्लिट. स्प्लिट क्या करता है कि वो तुम्हारा स्पेस के ऊपर स्प्लिटिंग कर देता है कैरेक्टर्स को. सपोज इफ आई से फुल नेम डॉट स्प्लिट तो यू कैन सी कि ये हमारा तीन अलग अलग स्प्लिटिंग कर दिया. माइक अलग हो गया है, जस्टिन अलग हो गया है, रॉस अलग हो गया है, ठीक है. तो अगर हम लोग को कोई ऐसा सिचुएशन है कि हम लोग को स्प्लिट करके एक एक वर्ड वाइज रीड करना है तो हम लोग स्प्लिट यूज कर सकते हैं.
अच्छा,
तो ये डिफरेंट डिफरेंट फंक्शंस है, इसी को हम लोग ऐसे स्लैश स्लैश भी यूज़ कर सकते हैं। ये एक्चुअली वो स्पेस एक्सप्लिसिटली यहाँ पे हम स्पेस डिफाइन कर रहे हैं, ये एक और तरीका है लिखने का, ठीक है। एंड अगेन अगर आई वॉन्ट टू स्प्लिट एंड आई एम पासिंग दिस आई कैरेक्टर, तो आई को रिमूव कर देगा, मतलब जो हम लोग पास कर रहे हैं स्प्लिट के साथ बाई डिफॉल्ट स्पेसेस जाता है, तो वो स्पेसेस को रिमूव करके वी आर गेटिंग द स्प्लिटेड वैल्यूज, ठीक है। एंड इफ आई से स्प्लिट आई, तो वो क्या करेगा, जहाँ जहाँ उसको आई मिलेगा, ये आउटपुट है, तो यहाँ पे m के बाद i था, वो i को रिमूव किया, वहाँ से कट कर दिया हमारे स्ट्रिंग को, एंड k e स्पेस जस्ट यहाँ पे फिर एक i एनकाउंटर होता, वो i को रिमूव करके द थर्ड वैल्यू दैट आई एम गेटिंग एज द आउटपुट इज n रॉस, ठीक है। तो i के बेसिस पे इट इज स्प्लिटिंग द वैल्यू। तो स्प्लिट हम लोग बाई डिफॉल्ट स्पेसिंग पे करते हैं, अगर नहीं वी वॉन्ट टू स्प्लिट बेस्ड ऑन एनी अदर कैरेक्टर, कुछ भी हो सकता है, वो एक नंबर भी हो सकता है, वो एक स्ट्रिंग भी हो सकता है, वो कोई स्पेशल कैरेक्टर भी हो सकता है, उसके बेसिस पे वो हमारा स्प्लिट करके रिकॉर्ड्स दे देगा। तो दीज आर डिफरेंट फंक्शंस, वेन एवर रिक्वायर्ड यू विल हैव टू यूज दिस, ठीक है। आई नो इतना याद रखना मुश्किल है, लेकिन जैसे इन डेली बेसिस अगर क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करोगे या रेल्स एप्लीकेशन में भी, अगर तुम्हारा रूबी का कुछ स्ट्रिंग स्पेसिफिक फंक्शंस जो यूज़ करते हैं, उसमें हम लोग साइज ऑब्वियसली बहुत जगह साइज चेक करना पड़ता है, इंक्लूड यूज़ होता है, इक्वल इक्यूएल इक्वल, ये सारे में डिफरेंस अच्छे से पता होना चाहिए, ये सारा नॉर्मली यूज़ हो रहा है। देन डाउन केस अप केस, स्वॉप केस नहीं यूज़ होता है इन जनरल, डाउन केस एंड अप केस होता है। सपोज कि फ्रंट एंड से ईमेल आया, यूज़र ने ईमेल जो है वो कैप्स में रख के तुम्हें सेंड रिक्वेस्ट कर दिया, ठीक है, बैक एंड में, तो बैक एंड में तुम बिफोर स्टोरिंग टू योर डेटाबेस यू कैन लाइक डाउन केस ऑल द कैरेक्टर्स एंड यू कैन स्टोर द वैल्यू, ठीक है। जैसे जीमेल में भी कैपिटल और स्मॉल दोनों अलाउड होता है, तो वो मे बी बैक एंड में डाउन केस करके अपने डेटाबेस के साथ मैच करता है, क्योंकि अगर तुम कोई भी केस सेंसिटिव दोगे जीमेल में, तुम देखना कि तुम्हारा वो जीमेल अकाउंट खुल जाता है, चाहे तुम कैप्स में दो स्मॉल में दो, वो उसमें कोई वैलिडेशन नहीं है। वैसे हम लोग भी वो क्या, लेकिन बैकएंड में जब तुम्हारा जीमेल ओपन होगा, तुमको अपना आईडी जो है वो स्मॉल केस में ही मिलता है, तो मे बी वो लोग जब रीड करता है तो वो लोग स्मॉल केस करके ही रीड करता होगा, राइट। तो वैसे ही हम लोग के केस में भी कर सकते हैं, सपोज यूजर लॉग इन करने जा रहा है, उसने सेट ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स दिया, हम लोग डाउन केस करेंगे एंड देन उसको मे बी स्टोर करेंगे, या फेच अगर लॉग इन करने के लिए हम लोग को मैचिंग करना है कि ईमेल आईडी डेटाबेस से मैच हो रहा है कि नहीं, तो क्योंकि हमने स्टोरिंग के टाइम पे डाउन केस किया था, तो जब हम लोग चेकिंग करेंगे तो भी डाउन केस करके वी कैन मैच, तो ये इस टाइम पे यूज़ हो सकता है। एंड स्ट्रिपिंग बहुत ज़्यादा यूज़ नहीं होता है, कभी स्ट्रिपिंग अगर कुछ कैरेक्टर्स हम लोग को आता है फ्रंट एंड से जो हमें चाहिए, कि अगर स्पेसेस एक्स्ट्रा कभी कभी यूज़र नेम में लास्ट में कभी स्पेस करके एंट्री कर देते, राइट, तो वो सारे केसेस में हम लोग स्ट्रिप करके अपना डेटा स्टोर कर सकते हैं। तो ये सारे यूज़र के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है, इस तो हम लोग डायरेक्ट कोड नहीं लिख के हम लोग डायरेक्ट फंक्शन यूज़ कर लेंगे, सपोज स्ट्रिप फंक्शन यूज़ कर देंगे, हमारा स्ट्रिपिंग हो गया एंड वी कैन स्टोर द पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू इन द डेटाबेस। सो आर जस्ट वगैरह उतना यूज़ नहीं आएगा, बट स्प्लिटिंग एंड डिलीशन मे बी इज बेस्ड ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट्स यूज़ होता है। तो ये कुछ सेट ऑफ स्ट्रिंग के फंक्शंस है दैट यू शुड नो। तो एक बार अपने एंड से तुम लोग देख लेना फिर से ये पूरे फाइल को, एंड फिर कुछ इशू हो तो हम लोग डिस्कस कर लेंगे, राइट। सो नेक्स्ट लेट्स कम टू हैशेस। नाउ हैशेस का कॉन्सेप्ट कुछ भी पता है?
नो मैम।
ओके, सो हैश जो हमारे हर एप्लीकेशन में हर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन में काम आता है, जिसमें हम लोग वैल्यूज़ जो होता है वो की एंड वैल्यू पेयर में स्टोर करते हैं, ठीक है। तो सपोज एरे में वी कैन की एंड वैल्यू पेयर में योर डेटा गेट स्टोर्ड, ठीक है। सपोज कि अब हम लोग के केस में अगर हम लोग एरे का एग्जांपल ले, तो एरे हम लोग एरे एलिमेंट्स को रेफर करते हैं थ्रू देयर इंडेक्स, राइट। एरे ऑफ जीरो वी से दैट फर्स्ट वैल्यू मिला। तो इसी तरह हैशेस में जो इंडेक्सिंग होता है, जो हमारा की होता है, वो हम लोग डिफाइन करते हैं, वो तुम्हारा कस्टमाइज्ड हो जाता है, एंड देन उसके कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग एक वैल्यू डिफाइंड होता है। तो सिमिलरली जैसे हम लोग एरे ऑफ जीरो बोल सकते हैं इज इक्वल टू द फर्स्ट वैल्यू, वैसे अगर हम लोग हैश डिफाइन करें तो सपोज अपना हैश ऑफ हम अपना की बताएंगे एंड वी गेट द कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग वैल्यूज, ठीक है? तो एक यहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है, इट्स लाइक की वैल्यू पर इट इज़ सिमिलर टू एरे एक्सेप्ट इंडेक्सिंग इज डन वाया एट्रीब्यूट कीज. मतलब इंडेक्सिंग वी आर परफॉर्मिंग बाय सम आर्बिट्री कीज और कस्टमाइज्ड की इंस्टेड ऑफ जो हमारा नॉर्मल इंडेक्सिंग चलता है एरे में, ठीक है? सो सपोज एक एग्जांपल है हमारा, जैसे इंडिया है, राइट? इंडिया है मेरा की एंड उसके लिए मैंने सपोज कोड दे रखा है, एसटीडी कोड है +91. तो ये अगर वी आर स्पेसि वी अगर दिस इज सपोज दिस इज स्टोर्ड इन एन हैश, सपोज हैश वन. सो अगर हैश वन ऑफ इंडिया करेंगे वी गेट द वैल्यू एज 91. ओके
ओके.
सो यहाँ पे यू कैन डिफाइन सपोज हैश, जैसे हम लोग एरे डॉट न्यू करके एरे डिफाइन होता है, वैसे ही हम लोग हैश डिफाइन करते हैं हैश डॉट न्यू करके. एंड देन सपोज हैश ऑफ 44, दिस 44 इसमें इसमें क्या हो रहा है कि डिफॉल्ट जो है सारे वैल्यूज जो है वो तुम्हारे एनी की के लिए, कोई भी की हो उसके लिए वैल्यू बाय डिफॉल्ट जो तुम स्पेसिफाई कर रहे हो वो दे देता है. तो यू आर स्पेसिफाइंग द वैल्यू हियर, नॉट द की. सो अगर हम हैश ऑफ 44 बोलेंगे, ये 44 भी कोई प्री डिफाइंड वैल्यू है, इंक्रीमेंटेड वैल्यू, ये की अपने आप बना लिया. तो जैसे हमारा नॉर्मली एरे में हो रहा है तो वो 44 पे भी कंट्री देगा एंड 11 पे भी कंट्री देगा अगर यू आर जस्ट स्पेसिफाइंग हैश न्यू कंट्री, ठीक है? ये एकदम बेसिक वर्जन है हैश क्रिएट करने का. ओके, सो ये बोल रहा है कि डिफॉल्ट कोई भी की अगर तुम लोग यूज कर रहे हो टू फाइंड द वैल्यू, यू विल गेट द वैल्यू एज कंट्री, जस्ट दैट. बट इसका मैपिंग कैसे हो रहा है? मैपिंग हमारा ऐसे डिफाइन होता है कि सपोज ये मेरा की है एंड इसका वैल्यू ये है, ठीक है? इवेंचुअली नेक्स्ट में आते हैं तब क्लियर होगा थोड़ा. अब सपोज कि यहाँ पे एक कस्टमाइज हैश बना हुआ है, मतलब हम लोग वी आर स्पेसिफाइंग की वैल्यू पेयर एंड ये ब्रेसेस हम लोग यूज करते हैं हैश डिफाइन करने के लिए. जैसे हम लोग थर्ड ब्रैकेट यूज करते हैं एरे के लिए, हमारा सेकेंड कर्ली ब्रेसेस यूज हो जाता है हैश के लिए, ठीक है? एंड यहाँ पे सपोज वी आर, अब यहाँ पे एरे के केस में वी आर ओनली स्पेसिफाइंग द वैल्यूज और जो इंडेक्सिंग हो रहा है वो इंक्रीमेंट कर रहा है 0, 1, 2, 3, जैसे हम लोग को पता है, या नेगेटिव इंडेक्सिंग भी वो इम्प्लिसिटली कर लेता है. बट हैशेस के केस में वी आर स्पेसिफाइंग द की ऑल्सो. सो इंडिया इज द की, वैल्यू इज 91. यूके इज द की, वैल्यू इज 78, राइट? नाउ इफ यू आर सेइंग लाइक पुट हैश ऑफ इंडिया, ठीक है? ये बस याद रखो, ये सिंबल होता है, इसको हम लोग नेक्स्ट क्लास में डिस्कस करेंगे. सो हम लोग को अगर इंडिया का वैल्यू चाहिए, वी विल से हैश एंड देन थर्ड ब्रैकेट में कोलन इंडिया, राइट? दिस इज द की वैल्यू. एंड इफ यू वांट द लाइक वैल्यू फॉर यूके, सो ये हो गया तुम्हारा, इफ यू वी हैव टू स्पेसिफाई द की यूके हियर, ठीक है? सो दिस विल गिव द आउटपुट एज, इसका की हो गया 91 एंड इसका की का वैल्यू 91 एंड इस की का वैल्यू 78, द आउटपुट विल बी 91 एंड स्पेस 78, राइट? ओके, इसको हम लोग रन करके एक बार चेक कर लेंगे. अब नेक्स्ट केस है कि सपोज कि तुम्हें एक और, जैसे हम लोग को एरे में एलिमेंट्स ऐड करना रहता है, राइट? तो या तो हम लोग फ्रंट से करते हैं या हम लोग बैक से करते हैं, शिफ्ट फंक्शन या पुश फंक्शन यूज कर रहे हैं. बट यहाँ पे देर इज नो कॉन्सेप्ट कि ये फ्रंट से आ रहा है या बैक से आ रहा है. वी आर स्पेसिफाइंग बेस्ड, क्योंकि हमारा वहाँ पे बेस इंडेक्स नहीं है, इंस्टेड हम लोग ने की डिफाइन किया है. तो इट डजेंट मैटर कि तुम्हारा फ्रंट से जा रहा है कि बैक से जा रहा है, वो इम्प्लिसिटली तुम्हारा हैश क्रिएट करेगा. अगर तुम्हें एक वैल्यू इंसर्ट करना है, ऐड करना है हैश में, सो यू स्पेसिफाई योर हैश, जो तुम्हारा हैश वेरिएबल है, यू स्पेसिफाई योर की, दैट इज USA, एंड देन यू गिव द वैल्यू इक्वल्स टू वैल्यू. सो अब हैश का सिचुएशन क्या होगा? इंडिया 91, यूके 78 एंड USA 80. एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फेच द डेटा फॉर USA, देन अगेन यू हैव टू यूज हैश ऑफ थर्ड ब्रैकेट कोलन USA. ओके, सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू पुट दिस, सो आफ्टर दिस आर हैश विल बी अपडेटेड विथ आर न्यू की वैल्यू पेयर. एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू प्रिंट दिस, यू कैन यूज again hash of USA, you will get the value as 80. Okay, and instead of like if you want to delete any values, then just you specify delete the key value. So it for the key value pair, both key value pair will be deleted. So all the entry for, means this entry for UK will be removed from your hash. So let's run this and check. initially 9178. Why? Because of this, which was already defined, right? India 91 space,
yes,
UK 78. Then we are adding one hash value here, and then we are trying to put USA. The USA value is 80, therefore you get the output as 80. Okay, and now it has removed, deleted, suppose UK. Now if I try to print UK again, suppose UK, then you see you will get no data here because UK is deleted, right?
Okay. अच्छा मैम, अगर हम की वैल्यू पेयर दोनों को एक साथ प्रिंट कराना चाहते तो
ओके, वो नेक्स्ट स्लाइड में एग्जांपल है. सो इतना क्लियर है तो हम लोग नेक्स्ट स्लाइड में वी कैन प्रिंट ऑल द कीज लाइक दिस हैश डॉट कीज. वी कैन प्रिंट लाइक इफ वी यूज हैश डॉट कीज इट विल प्रिंट ऑल द कीज मींस इंडिया यूके यूएसए इज आल्सो देयर देन इट विल प्रिंट ऑल द कीज. If I want to print all the values, then you can call hash dot values where it will print 91, 78, 80 like that. Okay. And
okay,
if you want to print key value pair, then you have to use one looping here. Okay. So in case of array, what we are doing, we are suppose array dot each and we are only specifying do I suppose. Okay. So that is only specifying with the I value, which is suppose my index value, and we are fetching values based on index array of 0 then I plus 1 like that. Or you can also run array loop based on elements, right? Array dot each, then every time your element will be stored and you are trying to print the element. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So here in case of hash, since we have to have both the values, key as well as value, so therefore when you are trying to do looping in hash for each element, you are saying key and value. So this key and value will be set for every element. So in our first case, key is India, space value is 91. In the second case, key is suppose UK, value is 78. Okay, so every time it will go element by element, it will store the key in your key variable, it will store your value in your value variable. This is your custom variable, you can rename this, but every time what it will do, it will store your key in your first argument and value in your second argument, and you can print and check. So we can use this and run. Okay, so India 91, UK 78. So it will print as it is. India is in small case.
Okay.
So India will be printed in small case, then UK and the values correspondingly. So this value is printed with space. So you can see this.
And ma'am, if we want to print those key and values ka jo between mein ek colon hai, वहाँ पे कि एक कोलोन अगर हम लोग देंगे तो ऐसे ही प्रिंट हो जाएगा?
यस, हम लोग यहाँ पे जो देना चाहे, कोलन, डबल कोलन, ट्रिपल कोलन, जितना कोलन देना यू कैन गिव, इट्स अप टू यू.
ओके,
ठीक है. इंडिया कोलन 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 91, दिस इज फॉर प्रिंटिंग पर्पस. सो एवरी टाइम योर की विल बी स्टोर्ड in, so this is your variable, right? This is your variable part, because every time this key value is changing. First it sets the value to India, second and value to 91. In the second case, the value, key value is set to UK, value is set to 78. And apart from that, this is your string part. You can every time this particular string will be called, this put will be called, right? And here key and value will be changing, but your other string value will remain same.
Okay, got it.
Okay, so you can also perform looping in hashes. Okay, so now I guess the concept of hash is clear. So hash is nothing, you can compare hash with your array, where you know that in hashes your keys you have to specify, those are arbitrary keys or custom keys, but instead if you are using arrays, then you can have your keys as your index, right? Those are predefined. You fetch the value based on index, but in case of hashes, you can fetch the value based on keys. So वहाँ पे क्या है? We are if we want to suppose fetch the fourth element. So you have to run the loop from your if you don't know like any value is present at the fourth value, then you have to run from your first loop first index to the fourth index. But here what happens? यहाँ पे fetching time बढ़ जाएगा क्योंकि you if you know the key, you can directly get the value, right?
Yes, but
so that's why we use hashes. So this is the basic way of adding and deleting value. If you want to print keys, you can directly go for dot keys, dot values, and if you want to print key value pair like this, then you can use your each function, which is already defined as a looping function. Okay, so next we have blocks. So now we will learn about these. So just a second. Okay, so blocks is nothing but chunk of data or chunk of code. So when we say like this, we have defined any block. Any block means suppose a function block, or it can be an looping block, or it can be a conditional block, right? So it is just you are defining suppose anything within like in case of Java, you are specifying something within braces. You can say that those belong to a block of code, right? The concept remains
yes,
same, but here we are using a block where we say that block, we say block ends when we encounter one end statement, and again it starts based on various block. If you go for functional block, you say it starts at def and it ends at end, right? If you have any looping block, you say that whenever you encounter suppose each, that will be the starting of the block, and when you encounter end, that is your end of the block. Okay, now suppose here I have taken an example. This is a functional block, and a block is invoked when the function with the same name is called. So suppose if I say this is the function that I have defined, but I want to call this function. So in that case, I have to call the function with the same name that is specified with as the function name, right? And there is a concept of yield, which actually suppose in this case, suppose you are saying that, okay, I'll take this as an example and I'll show you. So if I say I don't pass anything here, okay, just don't focus on these lines as of now, keep it very basic. So this is a test function. It says like put you are in the method test, okay? And now when you want to print this, the third line, if you want to print this, you have to call your function. So it will work, your block will be executed when it is called from somewhere. So suppose I am calling it after the function is defined, right? So if I run this as expected, the line should be printed. Okay, so you say it says that you are in the method test, right? Because you are calling your method after this. Is this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now if I want to suppose pass any value, or suppose let's take an example like this, where I'm suppose removing or just a second. Suppose I'm not passing anything, right? It says puts this. So we are passing a block. Again, we are passing a block with our test function. So if you want to print this block, you have to call this particular block, right? So that is achieved by your yield function. Yield function actually calls anything which is provided with your function. So can you guess the output of this?
Ma'am, samjha nahi.
Okay, so suppose
yes, seventh line pe test.
Okay,
test ke baad mein jo puts.
No problem. इसमें क्या हो रहा है कि सपोज फर्स्ट सिचुएशन में मैंने यील्ड वाले लाइंस हटा दिए, वी आर डूइंग जस्ट व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, वी आर जस्ट हैविंग वन लाइन विच इज प्रिंटिंग समथिंग, राइट? नाउ हाउ दिस विल बी प्रिंटेड, व्हेन यू आर कॉलिंग दिस फंक्शन, अंडरस्टूड? दिस इज योर ब्लॉक ऑफ कोड दैट यू यू वॉन्ट टू कॉल इफ यू वॉन्ट टू प्रिंट समथिंग और डू एनी ऑपरेशन विच इज गिवन इन दिस ब्लॉक ऑफ कोड, राइट? सो वॉट आई एम डूइंग, आई एम जस्ट कॉलिंग दिस फंक्शन, I am not passing anything here, I am just calling your function. So it will print you are in the method test. Now suppose you want to pass a particular block with this test function, again you want to pass something. Now I want this block to get executed, right? You are calling test with some block of code, you want this to get executed. So this will only execute when you find an yield function in your def test method. I will repeat. So this block, this puts you are in the block, will be executed when we are calling test. When it will be printed in, when we call test, and whenever we encounter the line yield, it will print the, it will actually yield the value which is passed to test while calling.
Okay,
I will run this so you get the clear picture. So what happens here, you see, first line is yield, right? So it will yield whatever is passed as the block with the test. So when we are calling test, we are passing something, so yield will just call this, nothing else. Okay, so therefore when you call yield, this is your keyword, yield is your keyword, what it will do, it will just look for the argument or argument code, you can say, or argument block which is passed with test, it will print this. So you see it says you are in the block, right? Then next line is put this, so again this line will be printed, method test one, and then you are again calling yield. So this will again print whatever is passed to the test block. Now is it clear?
Yes, ma'am. It is clear.
Okay. So if I say one more time yield, again, you will see that this block is again executed.
Yes, ma'am.
Yield only prints the value which is passed to the function call.
Function call. Okay.
Okay. Now there is another case when suppose I want to also pass a value. Suppose, so if I say not this case, if I say the above case, you can see it also accepts a value I, right? So you are in the block and you want to print I as well. So this I will be fetched with my yield. So if I say yield 5, this 5 will be set to I value and you will get the output as you are in the block and this 5 will be printed, right? If I say yield 100, it will give the output as 100. So you can see 5 and then the next. Now I am not passing anything, so it is not printing my I value. Is this
okay?
Clear? I will just
yes, ma'am.
Copy paste here. So you can compare. Okay, so first of all, what will happen when this test will be called? So it will go for the first line execution. Yield 5 means 5 will be set because it is accepting one value. So the output is puts this. Okay, the output will be this, this line. So the output is you are in the block and the value 5. Okay, so you can also set values with yield. Then the next line will be executed, which is you are in the test method, right? Then the third line will be executed with the value 100, so you are in the block 100, and then we are calling yield without any data, so this I will not be set, so you will only get you are in the block. Now
okay,
is it
ma'am.
Clear? So
yes, ma'am.
This is just a concept of block, so it will just execute the set of lines that you are defining inside a block. So this is a block of code, so every time you are like when you are in the line 2, it will perform its operation, it will move to line 3, then it will move to line 4 and line 5, and it will complete its work. So okay, so in block you have defined a set of operations, so every time when you are calling it, it will run all my expected executions and it will stop whenever your end word is encountered, just that. ओके सो वी दिस
ओके
इज
मैम,
योर फंक्शन ब्लॉक ऑफ कोड. सो आई हैव गिवन एन एग्जांपल टू स्पेसिफाई. सो नाउ इज दिस क्लियर? सो इफ आई इफ यू कैन सी द आउटपुट इज यू आर इन द ब्लॉक 5, देन यू आर इन द मेथड टेस्ट, देन यू आर इन द ब्लॉक 100. ओके सो दीज
यस
आर
मैम.
जस्ट ब्लॉक एंड यील्ड विल एक्चुअली कॉल विथ योर फंक्शन कॉल पैरामीटर ब्लॉक ऑफ कोड. ओके सो नेक्स्ट जस्ट कीप योर फोकस ऑन प्रॉक. दिस इज अ लिटिल कन्फ्यूजिंग, प्रॉक एंड लैम्डा. सो आई विल टेक डिफरेंट एग्जाम्पल्स सो दैट यू डोंट गेट कन्फ्यूज, बट यू हैव टू चेक दिस अगेन एंड अगेन बिकॉज यू टेंड टू फॉरगेट द फंक्शनैलिटीज. ओके सो प्रॉक इज अगेन, आई विल रीड दिस. प्रॉक is the ability to take a block of code. It will take your block of code within, it can be within do and end or it can be within braces. Okay, so you can see
okay.
proc, suppose this is the way of defining proc. In proc you are saying do end, right? Your set of code will be between do end or within braces. Okay, now it will wrap it up in an object called proc. Okay, so this set of code will be wrapped up in an object, in a proc object. So in case of block, you are not storing anything, or block of code is not stored in an object, but here proc is storing your set of code in an object. Okay, and that is stored in a variable. So again you can see this proc.new is actually creating an object of your block, just that.
Okay.
And this is stored in a variable. Suppose welcome is your variable. Okay, and you can run the code in the block whenever you feel like, more than once if you want to. So it's just like your function, but it is defining your function or the block of code. It is creating an object out of it, so that whenever you want to, suppose you want to print hello multiple times, so again and again you are not saying put hello, put hello, put hello every time. You will just call this with the help of your variable welcome. Okay, so when I say welcome dot call, it will call my proc function. Okay, so you don't have to again write the set of code or the we can say the functionality. You don't have to write. This is a simple one, it's just printing. When there are complex functionalities where you know that these set of code will be repeated, right? So every time you don't have to repeat your logic in your code. Instead, what you can do, you can just call the variable which is assigned to this functionality. Okay. So we have a concept of proc where, again I will repeat, it will take the block of code, it will wrap it up in an object. Okay, so welcome is an object of proc. Okay, and this you can say it will wrap it up in a variable, right? And you can use this variable whenever you want to repeat your functionality. Okay, so this
okay.
is a simple one. I will just take and run this. So as expected, the output is hello, right? Now you can see welcome. Now last day I mentioned you can check the class of the variable with class function. So dot class, if I do dot class, you can see that it says proc, means
proc.
It is the object of class proc. Okay, so proc is already defined class in Ruby, so you can directly use this. And the syntax is very simple. You have to use proc dot new. Okay, and then whatever logic you want to provide, you can use either do end, or in the second case you can see you can also use braces. And then you have to you store that in a variable, and you can call that variable with the help of call function. Okay, so I'm not running this will also work. So let's take different examples for proc. I will share this file with you. I tried to take as many as possible. Okay, so let's take this one by one. So first of all, this I have already covered, right? So welcome.
Yes,
Proc
ma'am.
equals to new. You can define your code in within braces, and it when you are calling, you say that proc dot, sorry, welcome dot call will actually call your proc. Okay, so this will work. Now let's take this example. So this is again a block of code, right? Where we have an array, we are doing each and every time what we are saying, like put, again we are putting it, means inside this block we are saying put n into 2, right? So what is the expected output of this?
Ma'am, it will be 6, 4 and 2.
Right. So if I only consider all our comment, right? So if I run this, sorry. It will be 6, 4 and 2, right? So this is your block of code, okay? This is not your proc. You can replace this with proc as this one. So what it's doing, again proc.new, and I have used braces, I have used this this logic which is defined inside each. I am just saying put n into 2, right? Now this is stored in your variable proc underscore res. Okay, proc result. Now what we are doing, this logic we will not be repeating. This logic is stored in a variable, right? So whenever we want to suppose use this n put n into 2, we are not specifying this line again and again. Instead, what we will do, we will just pass the variable and we will also have to use this ampersand, okay, to refer to this particular instance. Okay, so this will also work in the same way. So the expected output of this is again 6, 4 and 2. Okay, understood. So why we are not using block? Because again, if there is a situation where we have to repeat some set of operations for any, suppose herein we have taken the example of a particular array, right? So if I want to repeat this, we are not going to define it again and again. Instead, we will be defining the logic in a proc instance, and we can just use this variable, right? So again, you can see I have used dot each, then again I have called this, right? Again, this can be used. So every time you are not specifying this set of code. This is a simple one, you can repeat. But in case of complex logic, you don't have to repeat your block again and again. Instead, you can refer with the help of a variable. So the output, as you all know, all these will be multiplied by 2 and you will get the result. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, let's move to another example. If this is clear, then okay. So in the second case, there is a situation. Okay, let's come to this later. I will cover this later. Okay, so the second case is this. Can you guess the output? This is a simple one.
X to the power 3.
Yes.
Okay.
So now what I am doing here, I am calling this cube function, right? This is the variable. I am calling this with a value 3. Since it is accepting a value 3, therefore
yeah,
I am calling it with a 3 value. So again, if you want to call this function, you have to use this dot call with the variable. So it will actually set the value 3 to my x and it will return me, since it is double star means power. So 3 to the power 3, which is 27, right?
Yes,
there
ma'am.
Is another way of defining a proc variable, which is this. Instead of using proc.new, you can also use a keyword small proc, which is a replacement for proc.new. This is already defined. Okay, so either you can go for proc.new or you can also go for proc keyword. Both will work. So in your second case, again this keyword is given. So this particular logic or proc instance is given the logic of, again, power 2 means squaring. This is stored in a function. So this is just like your function, right? Where you are suppose you have a function which returns the square. Instead, you want this is handled in one liner. You have to create one proc object and your work is done. So this is just like your function, and when you are calling this function, you say dot call and you are specifying the value. So can you guess the output of both? So first is 27, the second is 3 to the power 2, which is expected as 9, right?
Yes. मतलब ये प्रॉक जो कीवर्ड है ये यूज करना मैंडेटरी है बिकॉज इट इज अ प्रॉक.
When you are trying to create an proc object, ठीक है,
यस सर.
you have some logic in your mind, you know that this logic will be used by various people, okay, so you can define a proc object, a public proc object you can define, and that different functions can be means different and whenever required we can call your proc method with the or proc object with the help of the variable that you are specifying, right? Instead of defining, suppose मुझे वही लॉजिक चाहिए जो
तुम्हें.
Now
is it clear? Yes,
ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Sometimes it got choked.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So instead of defining the logic again and again, we can have the logic placed in a proc object, and every time whenever someone requires that logic, he or she just call, use it with the help of a variable call. Understood?
Yes, sir. But if we want some matlab various procs agar hum log chahe to uska kisi matlab 1 2 aise karke naam deke use kar sakte hain.
हाँ, मतलब लाइक आई हैव मेंशन, सपोज दिस प्रॉक ऑब्जेक्ट इज इट इज टेकिंग वन वैल्यू, इट इज रिटर्निंग द क्यूब, राइट? सो आई हैव डिफाइंड द प्रॉक एज क्यूब, सो दिस क्यूब वेरिएबल वेन एवर इट विल बी यूज्ड इट विल रिटर्न द क्यूब ऑफ द वैल्यू दैट इट इज पासिंग लाइक दैट. ओके, सो दिस इज अनदर प्रॉक. Another proc, I have defined the proc with the variable name as square. So whenever this square will be used in anywhere, suppose if this is a public, so in anywhere whenever I am trying to call this square with a variable, it will actually call my proc method and it will return me with the square value. So you can have any number of proc object you want. So these are the two ways.
Okay.
Either you can use proc.new or you can just go for small proc. Okay, so if this is clear, we can move to next example. But before that, I have to consider this first. So here what happens, you can see like it takes two variables, n and I, right? You are defining an object where you are passing the arguments as n and I, but you are only using n into 2, right? You are not using I. So in this case, proc will not give you any error, okay? It will just ignore your extra variable and it will return with the value of n. So if I say 3, 2, 1 and I am calling this particular value, so every time n will be set, your first variable n will be set, and it will return n into 2, which is again 6, then 4, and then 2. Okay, so
okay.
So whenever you are passing any number of arguments, it here I have mentioned 1, it can be 2, 3, 4, depends, but based on the logic, it ignores the extra parameters which is passed. Okay, it will not give you an error, it will just ignore it. Okay, so I can run and show you, this will not give you an error. So you can see the output is 6, 4 and 2, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you just have to remember that proc ignores other variables that are passed to it. So basic I have considered. Now let's take an example, this one. This I have got these ones. Okay. So like I mentioned, suppose there is a case I am defining a proc.new and I have taken two variables, right? And I am printing suppose a to the power 2 plus b to the power 2. Okay. So this p is your proc object. So whenever you will try to print p directly, if you want to print p, you will get the output as proc and some hash which is defined. Okay. So this is the output that you get when you are trying to print p. Now what happens, suppose if I say p.call and I say you can either provide the bracket or you can ignore the bracket, call 1 and 2. So what it will do, it will set 1 to A, 2 to B, and it will print 1 to the power 2 plus 2 to the power 2, which is 1 plus 4, the output is 5. Clear?
Okay.
Till this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
बट
लेस कॉम्प्लेक्स.
लेस कॉम्प्लेक्स. हाँ, इंस्टेड ऑफ यूजिंग सपोज दिस, फॉर दिस आई एम पासिंग टू. ओके, आइदर यू कैन से ब्रैकेट 1,2 और यू कैन से स्पेस 1,2. बट वॉट इट
यस
विल
मैम.
डू, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट विल रीड द फर्स्ट कैरेक्टर विच इज़ फर्स्ट वैल्यू विच इज़ 1, इट विल सेट द वैल्यू टू ए, द सेकेंड वन विल बी सेट टू बी एंड इट विल इवेल्युएट अकॉर्डिंगली, राइट? सो आर द आउटपुट इज
ओके मैम.
5. बट वेन यू आर स्पेसिफाइंग एनी नंबर ऑफ वेरिएबल्स विच इज लेस दैन द रिक्वायर्ड, देन इट विल गिव यू एन एरर. सो वी वॉन्ट ए एंड बी, बट यू आर सेइंग ओनली वन वैल्यू, ओनली ए. इन दैट केस यू विल गेट एन एरर अनडिफाइंड दिस. सो अनडिफाइंड दिस इज कमिंग फॉर योर सेकेंड केस. सो यू इट इज नॉट गेटिंग अ वैल्यू बी, देयरफॉर इट इज सेइंग दैट दिस इज निल, दिस इज नॉट हैविंग एनी वैल्यू एंड यू आर ट्राइंग टू डू पावर ऑफ सम अननोन वैल्यू, right? In that case you will give get an error. So at least two variables are required when you are trying to call the this proc function. Is this clear?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, but in the third case when you are saying 1, 2, 3, right, but you are taking only two values, so both will work. Means first a value will be set, b value will be set, but since the third value is not required in your proc function, it will ignore the third value. Okay, and again if
okay,
I say
okay,
if I
yeah.
say like I don't I if I say I don't in your second case, suppose in this case if you're not using b and you're passing means this b is unused, okay, and you are saying that only a is there and you are passing suppose 1 and 2 both, again the second value will be ignored. Okay, so you can have any number of value in your proc, the others will be ignored, and you can also have any number of value in your call, the variable from which I don't know the value. Suppose I know a, I know b, second value, from third value proc doesn't recognize the third value, right? So that will be ignored. So you can add values more than the required, but you cannot decrease the value which is required from by your proc function. Okay, so in your first case two variables required, so two are passed, output is 5. In your second case two are required but one is passed, so you get the error. In your third case three is passed but only two are required, so you get the value as 5 again, because a will be set to 1 and b will be set to 2. So 1 square plus 2 square is again 5. 3 will be ignored. Clear?
Okay ma'am. Yes ma'am.
Okay, so this is one case of proc again. Okay, so let's try this question here. This one. Focus on this. So I have a function. This is a function, right? Inside this function, okay, so this function has a value, it is taking a variable factor. Again, now inside this function, it is returning a proc object. You can have a proc
okay.
object inside your function. Okay, instead of storing that to a variable, you are returning your proc object by your function. Now, what will happen? It will take the factor when you are calling. First of all, you will be calling your multiply times, right? So, when you are calling this multiply times, you will have your factor, means the factor value set, and then you will also have to pass your n value. So, let's move it one by one. So, suppose this var 1. Is your function variable that is actually storing the result from my function. Okay, so if I say I only pass 3, what will happen?
3 into factor. Var 1 equal to 3 into factor.
Var 1 is equals to n is not set. Only factor value is set to 3. Okay, so let's
okay.
move 1 by 4. What will happen? You have to check. If I only say
3, n into 3 yoga.
N into 3. N is not set. So let's check the output so I get the clear picture. Okay. So I am not putting. Just a second. You will see proc objects. You will see proc objects. Just that. You are passing 3.
Yes.
But you are passing 3, you are passing 10, right? But this proc is not returning you with a value because this n value is not set. right? So that's why this call will only return me with a proc object, just that. Okay, so when you are trying to print var1 and var2, you have the output as your proc objects. Now I want to print the value to my var. Okay, so in that case you have to specify n, and for, as we know, for calling the proc with a value we have to have call function. Okay, so if I say var1 call 16, var1 is actually having the instance of the function, so it has the factor value from here. Okay, and dot call 16 will provide me with the n value. Is this clear? Or you
okay,
can
ma'am.
Also
yes,
you can replace var1 with this. So what you are doing, you are calling the function, you're instead of variable I am calling the function, right? And then dot call whatever is expected by proc. So here you can see, here I am storing everything in a variable, and then variable dot call x is the proc variable that is required. I am passing this with the call function. So when you are using method in case of variable, what you have to do, you have to call your method with the number of arguments that you want to give, dot call with the value
call
that is expected by proc.
Yes, got it.
Okay, so now let's run this. Let's remove this. Okay, so both will work. Can you guess the output now?
Now it will be the first one will be 48, and second one will be there is a factor value here, so 50 hoga.
Right. So it's 48 and 50.
Yes.
Okay. तुम्हारा ना ये सांस बहुत जोर जोर से आ रहा है वीडियो में ऑडियो में.
ओके
सो आई गेस अब क्लियर है. वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज फंक्शंस विद प्रॉक व्हेन यू आर ट्राइंग टू रिटर्न एनी प्रॉक ऑब्जेक्ट. देन इंस्टेड व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू प्रोवाइड द सेट ऑफ आर्ग्यूमेंट्स रिक्वायर्ड बाय द फंक्शन. सो दिस इज योर फंक्शन कॉल विद द सेट ऑफ वेरिएबल्स दैट आर रिक्वायर्ड. And when you have to have one value with your proc, you have to use dot call when you are calling this, and the variable that you are passing here is set to the proc variable n. Now I guess you can also guess the output of this. Can you guess the output? It's already there.
Yes, ma'am.
So var2
dot call.
No, first of
yes,
all,
yes.
It will evaluate the bracket
where
one.
Two. Yes, ma'am. Where 2 will be 40, and then where 1 will be 3 into 40, that is 120. Yes.
Okay, now I guess you can work with proc, and you can see if you want, if you can call this with method. Okay, so again, this is your where 2, which is your method instance, the function instance, and we have the value 10 here, so factor will be set 10. And then you are calling that with 4, so this will be called once with a factor value of 10 and n value of 4, which is 40. Then this call, the total proc will have a value of 40, means n will be set to 40, and var1 has a value 3, so factor is 3, n is 40, so 40 into 3, which is 120. Okay, so let's run this.
Yes.
Output is 120. Okay. So I will share this file with you so that you have different functions for proc. Okay. So
okay,
run these, and if you face any issues, just let me know. So let's move to Lambda. Lambda is, if you have understood proc, Lambda is similar to proc, just it is a special case of proc. We will discuss the difference, and this syntax varies. Okay, so let's not take this complex one as of now. So it is just like a function without a name. Okay, it's and it is these are also stored as objects. So let's take examples one by one. Lambda. Okay, so again, like proc, you can also have Lambda instances, or let's take the second one. Can see here. So first of all, you can see Lambda instead of proc.new you are using lambda, and then you are defining a put function here. You are storing that in an object, because lambda will again return you the same way. It will take the block of code, wrap it up in an object, and you can store that particular object in a variable. So, and again, you, when you want to access this particular variable, you have to use a call function, just like proc. Okay. So the difference is, instead of proc.new, you are using lambda keyword here. So the same happens here. I will run both and I will show you. Again here, again lambda keyword is used, the logic is defined. Now here in this case, one argument n is required. So every time when you are like doing a looping with each, when you are trying to pass the logic here, every time n will be set and each value will be multiplied by 2. Okay, so the output of this will be 6, 4 and 2 as expected, and the output of this will be hello. Clear? So 642 and hello. So the only difference here is the keyword that we are using to define. Is this clear?
Sorry ma'am, mera mic
okay, is this clear?
Kaam to ek hi kar raha hai. Yes ma'am.
हाँ, this is a special case of lambda. Lambda vary कहाँ करेगा? I will let you know. Okay. So instead of lambda, you can also, we have a special character which is defined for lambda. I will cover this in the next example. Till this is it clear? We can also use,
yes,
instead of braces, you can also have your do and end loop. Again, you are specifying lambda, do this thing means puts hello, right? And then it will, when you are trying to call, you can just use welcome.call. So this will again print hello. Okay.
Oh,
so
okay.
This is same as proc as of now. Now again, you can see, instead of proc, what we are doing, we are defining a lambda instance. And okay, so one thing you can check here, suppose we take this one. When you're just like proc, when you're trying to print the class of lambda, you can see that it will give me the output as proc. Okay, so it is a special case of proc. If you are trying to define the class of lambda, it will say that it is a class of proc. Okay, so it has some difference with proc, but the logic and everything remains same, and it is again inherited from proc only. Okay, so the second way of defining, I can use here, it's instead of lambda, you can also have arrow sign. Okay, this will also work. Okay, I guess. Okay, so I have taken another example. I need to pass these. So till this, is it clear? Lambda, and then I'm trying to pass this x, and I'm returning the power of 3. So 4 to the power 3 will be returned, as you can see here. Is there 64, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So let's take another way of defining my lambda. This is the case. So what I'm doing here, I'm taking my name of the variable, that is calc. Instead of specifying lambda, I'm using this arrow sign, and the set of variables that is required will be given after this arrow sign, x, y, z. And the logic will be given in the braces. So this x will come out in my key if we are using this arrow. Okay. And instead of this bracket, we are using the first bracket. Okay. So again, the value that we are using, so x, y, z is expected. First, what we are doing, we are summing x and y. X plus y is stored in sum. And the next line, what we are doing, the sum value is set to the power of z value. Okay. So if I say I want to call this calc, so calc.call, and I'm passing 4, 2 and 3. So the expected output is 4 plus 2, which is 6, and 6 to the power 3. So the last line will be written. So 6 to the power 3 will be returned. 216, I guess. Okay. So you can see the output is 216. So this is again another way of defining a lambda variable.
Okay, I got it.
Directly you can go for lambda keyword, you can specify the values inside this if you are comfortable with that. But if you encounter this type of code, don't get confused. This is another way of writing a lambda function. I am not using lambda word. Instead, I am using this arrow sign. Okay, this is another way of defining a lambda function. Okay. And just like
okay.
we use call function to call our object with the variables or the values, in the same way we are using cal.call and the set of values is passed. Okay. Now the case where you find the difference. So as we have seen in proc, if I say I pass I, right, it will ignore it and it will just evaluate based on n, right? But in case
yes.
of lambda, these are not ignored. You will find an error if you specify something which is not expected. Okay, so if I run this, you can see you will get an error. It says given 1,
wrong
expected
number
2, right? You are saying
okay.
that you are giving 1, you are giving each set of values, so every time n will be set, but you are specifying that you need 2 values. So that's why it says given 1, expected 2. Okay. So it will not ignore this I, instead it will want you to provide the value of I explicitly, okay, which is not the case of proc. So this is the basic difference between proc, where you will see that proc will ignore my extra variables, but lambda will not ignore, it is a hard-coded value, so it will ask you to provide all the arguments, okay. So in this
okay.
case you will get an error. If you are working with lambda, if you are working with proc, it will be ignored. Okay, so let's take again same example with lambda. I will just explain it again. So again, what I am doing, I am taking these two calls, your function calls in variable, and instead what I am using, the only difference you will find is instead of proc.new, there is a lambda object which is returned. It will work in the same way. Everything works in the same way. Okay. So 48, 50 and 120 as expected. 3 into 16, 10 into 5 and then from this the same output. Clear?
Okay. Yes, ma'am. It is clear.
Okay. So again, let's take these set of examples that I've taken here. So here what I've defined. So lambda and two objects are there, just like proc, where we are specifying a and b, right? So a to the power 2 plus b to the power 2 as expected. Now I am calling this lambda function with the two variables, so the output is 1 to the power 2 plus 2 to the power 2, which is 5,
yes.
right? Now if I say, just like proc, if I say I have passed only 1, so in that case again it will give me an error like wrong number of arguments. Okay, it wants to, but it is specified with only 1, right? Now in our third case, so in case of proc, you see the third value is ignored, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You get the output as 5, but when you are
yes.
calling means when you are passing more variable or more arguments than expected, you, in case of lambda, you will get an error. Instead of output, you will get an error. Okay, so let's try to run these. If okay, so it will stop at error actually. So means after this line will not be executed because your 42 line will have an error. So I'm not running for the error one. Let's skip this. If you want, I can show you with error as well. Now let's take one by one or okay, so let's keep it like this. So
okay.
the first output is 5 as expected. Okay, five, right? And if I say I uncomment this one, so as expected it will give me an error, undefined ** for nil, okay, because the second value is not passed. So I have to comment this out. So in your third case, when you are passing more number of variables, you will get the output as 5. Can you see?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now,
I can see.
So this doesn't give me an error. Now, if I say I have defined a lambda, and if I say I call lambda for 1 and 2, so as expected, the value is 5. Again, okay. Now, if I say I have called lambda for only 1, so as expected, if it will give me an error that given 1, expected 2. Till this, it will behave same as proc. Now, finally, if I pass 3 arguments, it will again give me an error, wrong number of argument, given 3, expected 2. So this is the basic difference between proc and lambda that you can encounter. Apart from that, the logic remains the same, the syntax varies. So you can have lambda with dash and arrow, but you can, or you can use, in case of proc, you can go for a proc keyword like we have in our examples. Okay, so let's run this also. So can you guess the output here? So what it is doing, this is the lambda.
Lambda do string.
Do string means
yes.
This is ended here, right? And so this is
yes.
your lambda object. This is returning something. Now every time it is taking a string value, right? So I'm so with call you have to specify your string value. Now what happens? You have said that I have specified the value as try, right? So this string is set to try if you're calling with a try value. Now what happens? This string, it will check for the value. So this is matched. So again, this, there is no such thing will be returned. Just that. Clear? So we have
yes,
an if else block inside the lambda where you are taking a string value, and this string value will be set when you're calling this variable L with a value. So L.call will be called, right? We'll call this lambda function with a value try. That try will be set to string and it will just return you based on the condition that is specified. So I can run this for you as well. Just a second. Okay, let's use this. Learn 6. So there is no such thing. Why? Because the value is try. Okay, I'm calling that for try. Therefore, this condition satisfies and then you get the output as there is no such thing. If I change this, right? So we get the output as do or do not. Clear?
Yes, ma'am, clear. And ma'am, I have a question.
Yes.
If we want to write this if and else statement with the ternary operator,
yeah, you
then
can
how
do so.
Can...
So instead of like, okay, so you can use like this. So if means the condition part is given first, okay,
yes.
Then question mark and you want to return something, right? So you can directly
yes.
set it like this.
Okay, just
colon the else part.
Okay,
like this. Okay, and
okay.
Instead what you're doing, you are returning this, returning some condition, just this one.
Okay,
I guess this should work. Do or do not.
Okay,
so you are just saying return the output of this, and the output will be based on my condition. Okay, so this is the condition, just the syntax is condition question mark. If this condition satisfied means if block, there is no such thing. And the else block, colon, and the else block.
Yes, got it.
Okay. So, let's take just the difference. So, proc and lambda are objects, whereas block is not an object. Lambda check the argument, while proc does not. And there is no dedicated lambda class. A lambda is just a special proc object. These
special
three things
proc.
You should
yes.
know. Okay. So we will discuss
okay.
symbols in the next class with some examples, and I will also add additional slides as well. Okay, so that by next class or next to next class, we will have all the basic knowledge of Ruby and we can start with SQL. सो यू
ओके
आई
मैम,
विल शेयर दीज फाइल्स विद यू, प्रॉक एंड लैम्डा वंस, ओके, एंड यू इफ यू फेस एनी इश्यूज यू कैन गो